from fully submerged docks along the waterfront to undrivable roads from East Boston to Everett, heavy rains brought serious flooding along the city's coast over the weekend. And floods like these are only becoming more common. Meteorologist and GBH News partner Dave Epstein joins me now to discuss, as does Kannan Thiruvengadam, a resident of East Boston, executive director of Eastie Farms, and the president of the Friends of Belle Isle Marsh, an environmental advocacy group. So, Dave, start us off by painting the picture of what we're expecting in the forecast for the next few days in terms of we got cold and in terms of flooding.
Yeah, so the good news is we don't have any real flooding to contend with over the next few days. We, of course, had the big flooding that occurred just a couple of days ago with the second storm in a row. Portland, Maine set an all-time record for the highest tide ever, and a lot of damage up along the Maine coastline down to the seacoast of New Hampshire. But over the next few days...
Mm-hmm. We saw some very dramatic images coming out of Maine.
Yeah, certainly incredible images, and losing fish shacks and wells, Kennebunk area seeing damage, Portland seeing damage. And again, this is the trend, Harpswell, Maine, this is the trend that we're going to be seeing over the next several decades.
So let's talk a little bit about that. Kannan, you have been looking at the trends generally. What are you seeing from where you are in terms of flooding trends?
We definitely see things getting worse. If you talk to my neighbor, Skip, who grew up in East Boston, he's noticing how in Constitution Beach, the water is ever closer and closer. And if you talk to Jay, who lives on Marginal Street, and she's been going to work at the art gallery on Border Street for 20 years, and she's noticing how the water is getting closer and closer. And scary is the term that she uses. So definitely seeing more flooding, not just from coastal due to storm surge flooding, but also from rain. We're seeing people on the top of a hill experiencing flooding.
So, Dave, yeah. Can you tell us a little more about that? Why are we seeing more heavier rains, more intense rains, or perhaps the time between rains not long enough, ground's very saturated? Why are we seeing these different forms, more of these different forms of flooding?
Yeah, most of this goes back to climate change. As the climate warms up, the air is able to hold more moisture, so we have more heavy precipitation events. New England and the Northeast is forecast to have more of these events than anywhere else in the country over the next century. We've also increased sea levels by 5 to 8 inches since the 1900 mark, and that's just an average. And the Gulf of Maine is the fastest warming body of water on the planet. So that adds to it because we have thermal expansion of water. So all of these things are combining to produce more fresh water as well as seawater flooding.
So we have a lot of people who watch these weather discussions and say, oh, come on, you're just pushing climate change as the thesis here. But, Dave, what will it mean in practical terms, whether you believe it's climate change or not? What are we going to see in terms of intense rains and flooding? Is it possible to say flooding ahead in the next few months?
Yeah, I mean, in the next few months, we don't know. That's sort of weather as opposed to climate. But in the background is this increase in sea level rise. And so over the coming decades, by the middle of the century, we're going to see more clear flooding days. In other words, there won't be a storm and we'll see shore roads being closed down. This is already happening down in places like Miami and across the peninsula of Florida. And as the sea level continues to rise, if there's a storm that coincides with the high tides, we will start breaking more and more these high tide records, and we're just going to see more and more damage. We actually lucked out last week that we didn't have a lot of wave action, and it was only one high tide. The blizzard of 78 was three.
And Salem experienced some record flooding. They talked about a breached seawall. Very, very dramatic views from residents in Salem. Dave, is that unusual?
I mean, it's not necessarily unusual to have coastal flooding. What's happening is, as the climate continues to warm up, that the flooding we're seeing is just becoming more frequent. So these events, which maybe were once every 100 years, start becoming once every 80 or once every 70. And then that gap just starts shrinking. And that when you hear that once every 100, it's not literally once every 100. It's the odds of that occurring. And those odds are shrinking. So we will see more of these flooding events as we have more storminess and the sea levels continue to rise.
So, Kannan, people still think about this when there's a major incident. They think about it in the midst of a flood. But then they say, oh, well, this is once every 70 or a once every 80-year event. It doesn't seem that urgent. Do you think that you're hearing from people right on the ground who are having more frequent basement flooding? Do you think we are taking this seriously enough in terms of planning for it, fortifying? There is a Boston resiliency plan. Are those projects moving fast enough, you think, to mitigate any of this?
Climate change is definitely way too aggressive in comparison to the steps we're taking to combat that. So the chronic problems are not really that well understood or neutralized. And you're right, Liz, we only really respond to it when it's acute. But here on the ground, people are beginning to see the trend, and it's increasing and it's increasing. Yes, there are plants, but if you walk onto the Greenway in East Boston, for example, and you notice that the flooding has now blocked the way, you can't walk. That is a safe space for people to walk with their kids. And if that's blocked, now they don't have that safe space. Or you go to the Harbor Walk, you try to walk there, and that's blocked. The very idea of people having access to the waterfront is out the window and into the ocean. And that's kind of increasing. That trend is definitely increasing. And I don't think we're matching the crisis, the pace of the crisis with our actions.
Dave, do you see the appropriate sense of urgency? You're familiar with resiliency plans. You're familiar with the idea that you have to protect some of these communities. Do you think there's enough urgency now about the issue?
Yeah, I think that in some camps there is urgency. I think that there is a misconception with the public on just what is going to happen and that these events will become more frequent. So we hear things like not once every 50 years, once every 100 years. But again, that's just the odds that it's going to occur. It still can occur more frequently. And as these events occur, we're just going to see more damage. And it's not only just coastal flooding, as you mentioned, it's also river and stream flooding because of the heavy precipitation events. I mean, if you think about it, we were in a drought a little over a year ago, and now we've had some of our rivers at some of the highest levels we've seen this time of the year ever recorded. So it's also the fluctuation that we're seeing between these events of dry and wet.
Okay. Dave Epstein, Kannan Thiruvengadam, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.